Hello everyone. This video is about your favorite topic from CCM, that is Carrier Sense Multiple Access, also called as CSMA. Well, these are the questions that are frequently asked in the university exams, which is right now the most important thing for you guys. The another important question that may come to your mind is why CSMA? Not only because it is a part of the syllabus, but technically it is a network protocol that listens to or senses network signals on the carrier medium before transmitting any data. CSMA is an improved version of Aloha. Now, Aloha is a simple communication scheme in which each source in a network sends data whenever there is a frame to send. However, Aloha risks collision with other users' message, and thus CSMA was developed. Now, CSMA is a part of Media Access Control Protocol. Carrier Sense Multiple Access Collision Detection, that is CSMA-CD, is a protocol for carrier transmission access in Ethernet networks. It has continuous transmission and reception for collision detection. Collision is detected by monitoring the energy level of the carrier. If the energy level is abnormal, that is, it is double than the normal, the collision has occurred. Another protocol is Carrier Sense Multiple Access Collision Avoidance, that is CSMA-CA. Unlike CSMA-CD, CSMA-CA acts to prevent collisions before they happen. In CSMA-CA, as soon as node receives a packet that is to be sent, it checks to be sure the channel is clear. If the channel is clear, then the packet is sent. If the channel is not clear, the node waits for a randomly chosen period of time and then checks again to see if the channel is clear. Going forward to the access modes of CSMA, the question asked in the university are as follows. The first is one persistent. In this method, after the station finds the line idle, it sends its frame immediately. This method has the highest chance of collision because two or more stations may find the line idle and send the frames immediately. The second is non-persistent. In the non-persistent method, a station that has a frame to send senses the line. If the line is idle, thus it sends immediately. If the line is not idle, it waits a random amount of time and then senses the line again. The third is P-persistent method is used if the channel has time slots with a slot duration equal to or greater than the maximum propagation time. It works with probability. If the probability is P, the station sends its frame. And with probability 1 minus P, the station waits for the beginning of the next time slot and checks the line again. This is the end of the video, and we hope you understand something at some point. And if you do not, you can watch the video again. Thanks for watching.